What's going on, everybody? Z here. Welcome back to some more Subnautica. So we are back. We're doing the things, doing the stuff, having a good time, hanging out. Hopefully you guys are having a wonderful day, or as good of a day as you possibly can. Anyways, what are we doing? Well, we are hitting stuff, apparently. Oh, God. All these poor fish. Anyways, we are going to head back to our base, and we're going to get some upgrade action going here. Now, I collected a whole bunch of stuff, so hopefully we will be okay and have about everything we need. I have a feeling we have to go out and get some, you know, like titanium, stuff like that, you know, the random bits and bobs. My goodness. You know, it's kind of crazy how loud it is when you hit like a singular little fish. My goodness. Anyways, if you guys enjoy the episode, don't forget to leave a like if you're new here. Don't forget to subscribe as well for some more. Now, I've had a lot of people ask me to play Subnautica Below Zero, and we are going to hop into Below Zero probably once we get towards the end of this series or finish the series up, then hop into Below Zero, knock that one out. Or maybe we could just start up a Below Zero series at the same time. I don't know. What do you guys think? Leave a comment down below. Super curious. But let's head on over to our base and let's get some upgrade action going here, shall we? And we are back. Oh, it feels good. Feels good. Let's go ahead and turn the engine off. And you know, one other thing that I would like to do right now as well is I'd like to grab these batteries and get a battery charger going. Okay, so let's open the locker here. Let's grab some copper. Let's grab some lithium, some diamond, some titanium, some gold. And then we need to grab probably a bunch of nickel, a little bit of silver. What else we got in here? I don't think we need that. Let's grab some crystalline sulfur and call that good for now. But like I said, I do want to build some power cell chargers on the main base so we can get these power cells charged up. We are on 50%. 50%! Because I left that. I left the rig for silent running. I left that going. So,
welcome aboard, Captain.
Oh, thank you. I'm so glad to be aboard. Oh, let's listen to the radio message, shall we? Oh. Okay. That was it, huh? That's fantastic. Fantastic. All right. So we need a depth module for sure. Ruby and plasteel ingot. Not too terrible. Not too terrible. You know what? Hold on. Let's get our power cell charger thing going first. That I think is probably going to be key for. Oh, we already have a habitat builder. Where is the power cell charging McDealier? Right there. Advanced wiring kit to ruby. Ooh. You know, maybe I should have grabbed more ruby. Advanced wiring kit. Oh no, we got plenty of ruby. Okay, cool. All right, so let's get a power cell charger in here somewhere. You know what? This could be a good place for a power cell charger. Right here, right? Sure. All right, we'll throw one right here. And then I'm gonna grab two of the dead power cells, throw them in here off of the Cyclops, because like I said, we're at like 50% battery. That's not a good time. Power cell, can I grab you? Just unload. Okay. That one's at 75%. That one's at 24. There's got to be some more empty ones over here. 0%. Unload. And okay, cool. So we'll get these two charged up for now. And then we'll get some upgrades made and then hopefully get the other ones charged up as well. Hello, Mr. Power Cell Charger. I'm going to need you and you. Fantastic. 1%. 2%? Yeah. Okay. So those are going to take just a little bit of forever to get charged up. Anyways, all right. We need some upgrades. So prawn suit, depth module, plasteel ingot, and ruby times two. Do I have plasteel ingots? Oh, I had a Cyclops engine efficiency module the whole time. Oh, we need to go put that in right now. I don't have any plasteel ingots. That's fine. You know what? Let's go ahead and drop some stuff off. Ooh, do I have nickel marked anywhere? I don't think I do. I don't. Let's go ahead and throw nickel in here as well. All right, that should be good. And now we should be able to go through. Ooh, crystalline sulfur. Do we have that one knocked out too? It should be in. Oh, nope, I don't have that one marked either. All right, there we go. Crystalline sulfur is in there. That one, apparently you can only have a max of like 8 or 9 items or whatever. But now I should be able to put all this in here. It should get sorted out all handy dandily like, and fantastic. Let's go throw this engine efficiency module upgrade on the Cyclops and then grab some more stuff, bring it over there. So we can do more upgrading. I have an upgrade. I have an upgrade. Upgrade. Ta-da! 300%. Wonderful. Wow. Why? That could have saved me a whole bunch of... Oh, well. Oh, well. It happens. All right. It's looking good. Everything should be fairly sorted. We're going to need a bunch of titanium, though. So I'm just going to go out and grab that right now. Yeah, we need it. Where is my sea moth? Okay, sea moth is over here. We're gonna take this bad boy out. We're gonna grab, you know what? I took the storage module upgrade off of it. No, I didn't. It's still right here. Open storage. Do I have any titanium in here? No. All right. So I'm gonna go grab some titanium. See you guys in a minute. Hey, look it. We're back. And our power cells are fully charged. That's wonderful. I do have space for them. We'll get to those in a minute. All right, so I gotta turn all this into titanium, but we have another message.
This is life pod 7. Coordinates attached. Pod is structurally sound, but the fabricator's bust. Requesting assistance. 7 out.
Signal coordinates corrupted. Approximate transmission origin recorded to data bank.
All right, so we got one titanium ingot. We need a plasteel ingot, which I do believe is lithium. Lithium. Hello there. I think it's 2 or is it 3? It might be. I think it's 2. Plasteel ingot. It's only 2. Fantastic. All right. So there's that. We needed that nickel and ruby to get our depth module mark 1. Okay, we still have that there. That's good. We need nickel. And we need ruby. And I think that's everything for depth module mark 1 for the prawn suit, maybe? Yeah, it is indeed. All right, now we're actually gonna look to see what we need for the depth module mark 2 for the prawn suit, because I believe there's a mark 2. If I'm not mistaken, depth module mark 2. All we need, we need kyanite. Okay, so I don't have any kyanite yet, so that guy is done. Where should I put the upgrades for these? I should store these somewhere. You know what, let's just go ahead and store them. We'll just store them in this guy for now. Perfect, so there's the depth module mark 1. We're just gonna leave it in there for now because I'd have to get the prawn suit out, you know, all that fun stuff. So we'll do that later. So depth module, good to go. Now we can't make that because we don't have the kyanite for that. The prawn suit jump jet upgrade, absolutely that's gonna have to happen. And I think that's actually the last upgrade that we're gonna be able to do for this bad boy. So nickel ore and crystalline sulfur, too easy. And jump jet upgrade acquired. Not even a thing. So we'll go jump that guy in here. Now, those are the last prawn suit upgrades we can do. We could look at the sea moth for upgrades, but I do want to get the Cyclops upgraded. We are going to be taking this guy down deeper, so we are going to need some depth modules for that. Let's go ahead and take a peek at what we're going to need. Depth module, plasteel ingot, and ruby times 3. That's easy enough. Let's see. What else do we have on this guy? So we have the Cyclops shield generator. I feel like we need that. I got to figure out how we need to make that polyaniline, though. So I think the primary ones we're gonna go with is obviously the depth module mark 1, the shield generator for sure. I would really like to get the sonar upgrade because the sonar upgrade makes things super easy to see. The fire suppression system, because if there's a fire on the Cyclops, it's super pain to put out and you can lose your whole Cyclops. I would like to get the repair, the docking repair, but I know we only have so many slots. I think we only have 6? Yeah, we only have 6. So, and we already have an engine efficiency module. I don't believe these stack, I'm not positive. So I could put a max of 5 on here. So we could put all 5 of those on there. And I think we would be good. So we might try to do that. Now, I don't know if there's a Mark 2 for this guy or not, as far as depth module goes. So we'll have to check that out as well. But it probably requires the kyanite crystal, if there is. So let me go ahead. Let me get up all that stuff. And we're going to go on an upgrade making spree. Oh, wait. I already have a polyaniline. I don't know how I got that. But hey, I got it. So I guess we'll just... we'll just use that guy. All right, if I did my calculations correctly, we now have everything we need to make all of those upgrades all at once. It's gonna be, like I said, one super huge upgrade making expedition that we're about to go on right now. It's gonna be a good time. Yes, indeed. All right, let's see. Let's make sure that I have the right quantities of everything. I should. And once you know it, that's all the upgrades. All right, now let's take a peek. Is there a Cyclops upgrade? Depth module mark 2. Oh. Doesn't require kyanite. Okay, so we're gonna go straight for that one because we already have the Cyclops depth module mark 1. Let's go ahead and get plasteel ingot and nickel ore. That doesn't sound too terrible whatsoever. Do I have more lithium? Oh, I had 1 in here. Wait, do we have a fabricator here? Can I make another titanium? No. All right, so we should be able to make Cyclops depth module mark 2. Fantastic. And then, you know, I'm thinking about making the swim charge fins. Well, we're typically not out of our stuff too often, so that might not be worth it. Sea moth depth module. We're probably not going to be using the sea moth a whole heck of a lot, unfortunately. Now that we have the prawn suit and the Cyclops, those are kind of more fitted for the expeditions of the Lost River. So let's go ahead and put these guys in here. Let's get this guy fully upgraded. Depth module mark 2. Brush is 1,300 meters. I like it. Shield generator. Fantastic. Sonar upgrade. Absolutely. Repair dock. Absolutely. Cyclops fire suppression system. Oh yeah. Guys, we just got like all of the upgrades. It's amazing. It is super amazing. Let's go ahead and upgrade the prawn suit too. All right, Mr. Cyclops, man, you need some upgrades. Oh, we're gonna take storage off. Oh no, hold on. I think I have, oh man. let's pull all these out because our storage is about to drop, unfortunately. Well, never mind. We're gonna, let's go throw them in here. All right, storage has been cleared out. I moved everything to the Cyclops because why not? Let's go ahead and pull the storage off. Let's actually pull it from these ones. I don't think it makes a really a big difference. We need the jump upgrade and we need depth module. 1300 meters crush depth. Okay, so now this guy can go just as deep as the Cyclops, or the Cyclops can go just as deep as this guy, because I think, if I'm not mistaken, the prawn suit has the maximum depth of any of the vehicles in this game. So there's that. As far as upgrades, maybe we should throw, should we just throw the storage onto the Z-Moth for now? We might as well. Yeah, we'll just throw these on here for now. We're not gonna be taking out a whole lot anyways. Let's go ahead and grab these two off of here and we'll replace them with the power cells in here. And then we'll grab the other power cells that are semi-depleted. Get those guys charged up. Oh my gosh. We got like a whole new Cyclops here, guys. It's just upgraded to the max. It's ready for action. And we got these two guys charging up, ready to go. Maybe we should make a couple extra power cells for the sake of just in case, you know. I do believe I have some dead batteries. So let's see, there's a dead battery. There's, I think these are these all charged up 100%? What? Let's see, that'll give us, that'd be two extra power cells. Yeah, let's make those into power cells because we just need batteries and silicone rubber. So it's super easy. And then we'll just throw those into storage just in case our Cyclops is running low on power. We'll have some backups. Now, I know what you're going to say. You're going to be like, hey, you're going to be able to get the ion cells eventually. I know, but these are going to be for now because we're going to need them just for now. You know what? Maybe I should take some batteries too. Let's do that because some of my tools need some batteries. So we'll take three extra batteries as well. All right, and we'll throw power cell, power cell. Actually, let me just throw these ones on. Yeah, we'll get these ones charged or just thrown in here. So it's good to go. There's that guy and that guy. And then we'll just take the two off the charger once we're done. All right, we got some upgrades. Now, I think we haven't explored that precursor area yet. So we need to do that. I need to grab, activate the Cyclops fire suppression system. Oh my gosh, it's amazing. Pilot the sub. We should have a shield module deal. Oh, we do. Shield right there. Sonar right there. Activate the sonar. See, I love the sonar. It makes it possible to see stuff. All right, let's turn it off though. It does require quite a bit of power. So shield module, super fantastic. We're ready. We're ready for some things. I feel like we're ready. Okay. I need to make some, we need to make some of those tablets. I can't remember where that's at. I think it's personal equipment. Yeah, we need, oh, we don't have the ion cubes to make them yet. Okay. So actually, I don't even know where those, where the tablets that I have found went. Let's see if we can go find those guys. Here they are. Okay. So we have two tablets. That's super handy, but I think we're actually gonna probably use the Z-Moth here to go over to that precursor weapon thing that we saw that took down the sunbeam, unfortunately. And let's see, let's check our water situation here. I'm trying to grab the stuff off of this guy so we can have like a surplus of water because we're always thirsty. And I think we're pretty much set. Yeah, we're good. We got upgrades. This guy's upgraded. The Cyclops, everything. Everything has been upgraded. Now we should have a better jump jet too. Oh my gosh, it's so much better already. Like just the sheer speed in which we have control. Oh my gosh, it feels great. This was definitely needed. We can't access the prawn suit while in here, can we? No, we cannot. Let's access our upgrades. Let's throw our grappling hook back on here. That way I don't lose it. This is amazing though. Now we should also be able to dock this guy and it should repair. Oh geez. Oh geez. Should be able to repair this bad boy up. Health 100%. Yeah. Oh, I like it. I like it indeed. What's our power at now? 98. Well, looks, well, we're all right. But yeah, that's gonna end this episode, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed. We did all the upgrading things. I don't think there's anything else that I'm super worried about upgrading right now. We probably should make a propulsion cannon. That would probably be super handy. Maybe we'll do that in the next episode. But yes, next episode, we're going to go check out the precursor weapon thing. We're going to take the thing with us and do the other things and the more stuff. And I know, it's super descriptive. But maybe we'll also make the propulsion cannon too. And the repulsion cannon, because I know that's another thing. But we got upgrades in here. I'm super excited. Hopefully you guys are too. And yeah, leave a comment down below. Is there any upgrades that I missed that you think that I should be having right now? Because I know there's some things we can't get. And we need those kyanite crystals and things like that. So, but yeah, thank you guys for coming out. Have a fantastic day, and I will see you in the next one.